Well, Houston, we have a problem with my xTool P2. It is not cutting squares squarely. We have some squares that are unsquare. Let's check it out. Hey everybody, my name is Sam and welcome back to Samcraft. That's right, my xTool P2 desktop CO2 laser is not cutting things squarely. Even when designed, it's just not right. In today's video, I'm gonna bring you guys along as I investigate and find out exactly the steps to fix my machine, to re-square my gantry or make it parallel to the case, whatever is the issue, adjust a few things, and ultimately get my machine cutting squares squarely. Before we jump into this video and I show you how to fix and test things, I want you to know this is a completely unofficial fix. This video, these steps have not been approved by xTool, and your first point of contact, the first thing you should do is contact xTool customer support, tell them what issue you have, and see what they offer. So the first thing before you do anything beyond here, you need to figure out if you really need to do this or not. Does this fix apply to you? There are two different ways you can kind of go down this road to see if you need to do this or not. First and foremost, take a look at your gantry. Remove your little plastic door on the left side of your P2, bring your gantry all the way to the front, slide your laser back and forth, and see if the gap between your laser housing and the actual housing of your machine is the same distance. Is it parallel? The other more accurate way, and honestly the first way that I figured out I had an issue, is to try running and cutting out a square. Design something up in xTool Creative Space, make sure it is a perfect square, load your material, and cut it out. So what I've done is designed a 100mm square test file. It's in xTool Creative Space format, and I'll put that free file link down below. You can pick it up from my website. You're gonna want that for this project if you're following along for sure, because that's the exact same file that I ran to find out my issues, get my measurements, and it's gonna be my litmus test or my proof that I actually fixed it file when everything is said and done. As far as the tools you're going to need, the things that are outside of what you may normally have are digital calipers, although you really should have these already, a digital angle finder or digital protractor, and then machinist 1-2-3 blocks or square blocks. I've heard them called different things, but these guys right here. In addition to these, you're going to be using some metric Allen wrenches, a Phillips screwdriver, some masking tape for your lens adjustment, and I think that's it. But as far as specialty tools, these three are the ones that you may not already have. So with that being said, let's go ahead and run the file, run the machine as is, let you guys see my results, and then we'll dive into fixing the issue. Looking at my test square, I have a top face of 99.8 millimeters. That's fine with me. 2/10 of a millimeter off from 100 is perfectly fine. The bottom is 99.74. Again, not too bad. The left is 99.76 and the right is 99.74. So by just looking at the measurement of the faces, I would not think that something is really off. They're pretty close. No, they're not exact, but they're close, and you might think that's okay. However, looking at the diagonals, your measurements from corner to corner, one is 141.36 millimeters, while the other is 140.08. That's a pretty big difference. 1 millimeter difference on diagonals is a lot, and that should be your first indicator something's not right. Using my digital angle finder or my digital protractor, the top left corner is 90.4 degrees, top right 89.3, bottom left 89.2, and bottom right 90.4. Looking at these kind of does show me that what I'm having are a skewed results. It is kind of twisted, it's a little bit off, which would correlate with that gantry being out of alignment. So the test file shows something is wrong with my laser, and if you're here, you probably have the same results. What I'm going to do next is try and square up and parallel my gantry to the machine. For that, I'm going to turn the power off to my laser, absolutely turn the power off. Then I'm going to loosen the belt tensioners for my Y axis. You have one on the left, one on the right. That should alleviate the strain, and I'm going to try and push or pull the gantry left and right to get it aligned. After that, I will retighten my belt tensioners, getting the tension as close to same as possible on left and right side. Run the gantry back and forth several times by hand and see if I've got a fix. To gain access to loosen the tension on your belts, you're going to have to remove this. the front lower plate of your machine. Right inside the lip of your laser, there are six little screws that hold this plate on from the inside going out. Remove those and it'll carefully come out. You can pull it straight up and out. The reason you take this off is so you can get to the actual set screw tensioners built within the case, loosen the tension, and then take all the slack out of those belts so you can freely move the gantry around without worrying about stripping gears, breaking belts, damaging a stepper motor, or anything else. Once you have the front cover off, you can then have access to the front tension adjusting bolts, loosen them a good bit, go inside your machine, and then loosen the main bolt that you will see normally, and at that point, your belt should become really slack and enable you to move everything around freely. With the belts loosened, you're going to be able to tell you immediately have access, any ability to really twist and rack that gantry, which is what we want. We want to be able to square it up, make it perfect without forcing anything. So there's basically three different ways that I can think of that you could square your gantry up. First and foremost could be just push it all the way to the back wall of your laser, hold it in place, tighten the right side, tighten the left side, and call it good. Option two would be to bring the laser all the way forward, bring that laser head up against the wall till it stops, get a measurement on your right, lock it down, slide the laser all the way to the left where you have more free play, adjust it back and forth to the same measurement, lock it down that way. Or option three, which is the option I'm choosing, is to use a couple of machinists 1, 2, 3 blocks, lay them down on top of your bed, up against your front wall, pull your gantry up against the blocks, hold them tight, and then lock down your right and left belt tensioners. I'm going to go with this. I'm a fan of relative dimensioning, where you use physical objects to equate distances rather than relying on precision measuring and your ability to get them perfect. But if you don't have these, like I said, you can use one of the other two options. Get creative. I know you're creative. You'll get there. Don't worry. I have my laser in the middle so it doesn't hit my blocks. And also, I have the blocks far enough away from the edges so I can fit my hands down in here, tighten everything without moving any of this stuff around. The cool thing about the machinist blocks is they're referencing against the front, this black metal piece. It's a fixed object. It is locked in with your frame. And they also are registering with the gantry, not the laser head itself, which does have a tendency to flex. As I pull the left side tight, I can see a gap here on the right, and I can wiggle it by hand. Just having that much wiggle alone and only the belts keeping things square makes it obvious. This is obviously why it's gotten out of square, especially during shipment. This thing was delivered terribly by FedEx. It was tossed around, stored on its side, and it's a no-brainer that this is going to be something to do. In my opinion, this should be added to the initial setup of the machine because so many people have reported this issue, and seeing that all of the squareness relies on the belt tension and that there's this much play with the rails, just makes sense. So my procedure is I'm going to squeeze the right side, I'm going to attach my bolts and retension my belt. Then I'll go over to the left side, squeeze and hold it tight, and do the same thing over here. Once I'm done, I'll move this back and forth, re-referencing it against the machinist blocks over and over, make sure that the belts are keeping in time, it's not getting out of alignment, and then we'll move on to the next step. Yeah, that's right. I'm totally plucking the belts to get the same kind of sound, to adjust their tension as close as possible as I can. Okay, I have gone back and forth over and over and over, a lot of adjustments as you guys saw, and I have got my gantry as close as I can get it as possible. I would say if it's anything, it might be 2 or 3 paper sheets thicknesses off left to right at the farthest extremes of the gantry. That's going to be okay. It's going to have to be good enough for me because I cannot get it any better than that. I did end up loosening the two silver screws left and right on the where the frame attaches, hoping that would give me a little more leeway. I don't know if that made a difference, but I did tweak those a little bit, loosen them while I was moving things back and forth, and then of course tighten those down along with the belt tensioners and everything of the sort. With our gantry squared up, you're going to be tempted to go ahead and rerun your file to see how great and awesome it looks, but you're going to need to realign your mirrors and lenses just like you did or should have done when you first got your machine. Go ahead and run through that same procedure, because if you moved your gantry, you're gonna twist your mirrors out of alignment. Go ahead and run through that, dial that back in, and then run your test file again. Okay guys, fresh off the laser, with my digital angle finder locked down after zeroing to 90 degrees, how does it look? Hot diggity dog, we've got her fixed. All right, there you go. That's the fix, guys. You just have to do a little bit of minor surgery on your P2 machine. But hey, you know what? This thing has traveled across the world and it has not been loved on by anyone except for the manufacturer and yourself. So all in all, not bad. And I don't fault the manufacturer at all for this. To recap, what I did to fix was to run my first test grid file, found out that there was a problem, take apart the front cover, loosen the belts, using my machinist 123 blocks, pulled that gantry square and parallel to the front frame, locked everything back down, realigned my mirrors, ran my second test, and confirmed that all is well in Lasertown. At this point, all I have left to do is put the cover back together, clean everything up, and I'm ready to rock and roll. If you guys got any questions or comments, leave them for me down below. Remember, I am not xTool support. Your first line should be to contact xTool for support. But in the meantime, or if you just love to see stuff on YouTube and try and fix things yourself, hopefully you found this video and it was helpful. Take care as always, and I'll see you guys next time in the workshop. Thank you.